Hi everyone, NETFQ here. Today we're going to do some ratting in a VNI, Vexor Navy Issue. I'm going to be using two accounts, and the reason for this is I've just found that a very effective way of doing ratting sites. It's pretty hands off. There's just a couple of additional things you need to do. So what I'll do first, I'll just show you the two fits that I'm using. So this is my alt here that I'll be using, and the only thing I'll be doing with this alt is just orbiting and assigning the drones to assist my main character. So I'll just go over the fit anyway. So here's the fit. So what we've got for the rigs is we've just got the anti-EM screen reinforcer. We've got a defense field extender and a defense field purger. For the high slots, we've just got one drone link augmenter tech 2. For the mid slots, we've got a drone navigation computer tech 2. We've got our afterburner, which is 100 MN. And we have two large shield extender tech 2s. For the low slots, we have two power diagnostic system tech 2s, and we have four drone damage amplifier tech 2s. So this is going to be my alt. Now the drones that I'm actually using in this alt is the faction heavy drones. Now these do the same damage as the tech 2 drones, but the only reason I'm not using tech 2 drones in this character is she doesn't have the heavy drone level 5 skill at the moment, so she's having to use faction drones. But the damage is not the same as if you had tech 2, even though it says damage there, the damage modifier is actually lower just due to the skills. But still, it's up there. It's not that bad. So that's what I'll be using. For my main character, if you have a look at my main character, what we're using is we are using the Tech 2 drones. Now I'm using the Praetors, and the reason why is they do EM damage, which the Sansha drones, the Sansha rats don't like. So they are acceptable to EM damage, so hence why I'm using these drones. Now the rigs, the modules on this one, my main one, is slightly different, and I'll show you. It's the same rigs that we're using, same drone link augmenter tech 2, but I do have a auto targeting system tech 1. That's just so I can target 7 rats at any particular time, and it's auto targeting, which means if something attacks me, then it's going to auto target it. For the mid slots, I have a target painter tech 1. I have my 100 NM afterburner, and I have my two large shield extender tech 2s. For the low slots, is the same, two power diagnostics and four drone damage amplifiers. Now this here, the target painter, is very important. That's going to allow me to control what target the alt's drones are going to attack, and I'll show you that in once we get going. But that's the two setups, so pretty similar. The only difference is there the main has the auto targeting and the painter. So the other one, you have a look, the only thing we are missing is this drone navigation computer tech 2. I don't have that. I've replaced this with the as you can see on my main here, the target painter instead. So let's get going. So what I'll do is I'll first put both of them in a fleet. They both need to be in a fleet together, so I'll just go ahead and do that. And I'll say yes, join the fleet. Alright, so there they are, both in the same fleet. So I'll go and undock them both now. And make sure there's no bad people in local. All Right, which is not, which is fantastic. Right. So now that they're both in a fleet, that means I can also warp the alt as well to the same site. So let's try and go to a site. So just choose anyone, Sansha Haven, ITZ. So we'll say warp fleet to zero. And both of us should take off. Although my alt was slightly faster getting off the mark. So what I normally do, this is my alt here, just switch to him, or her I should say, because she's probably going to land first, she is. And my alt is just here as well, so my main is just here. So what I normally do is I just pick an object for my alt. I say orbit at 300, so I orbit at 30 kilometers, put my afterburner on, and release my drones. And with the drones, once I release, right click and say assist my main Arnon. Okay, and this is my main. So what I do is I do the same. I orbit at 300, I put my afterburner on, and I launch the drones. And yeah, then I just start shooting. So let's just go and shoot these rats. So as you can see, I've got my drones on my alt as passive, hence why they're saying idle at the moment. They're not doing anything, which is what you want. So if we come over to my main and I click on first target and start the painter, as you can see, if we go back over to my alt, now the drones are fighting that target that I selected. And you can see that there, and my drones are actually doing the same. Now I turn the target painter off, select another target, and I always find that once the target painter is on the target and the drones, return all those drones, because one of them's getting attacked, which is not very good. One of them's just died. Yeah, as I was saying, one of the things I like doing is when you put the target painter on a target and the drones on the alt character are actively attacking that target, you can turn the target painter off, and the drones are still going to attack the same target. Now I do that because you can't target something else until the cycle time is elapsed, and you don't want the drones to be idle, not doing anything. So it's always best to turn the target painter off just before the rat dies, so therefore you're quickly able to reactivate it on a new target. So now that all the rats are on me, I can launch these drones on the alt again, and hopefully the rats won't attack it and I can assist Arnon. Right, so let's do this. So alt's on there, my main drone's on this one. I'll turn the auto targeting on. So now this is attacking this guy. I can then turn the auto painter, sorry, the target painter off. And then wait for it to go, and then I can start it on this guy. So let's give that a go. Okay, my main drones can do that. That's just about died. Right, start the target painter. Boom, straight away, the alt drones are going to start attacking this guy. So it's very, very quick to flip target. So turn it off now. So it's going to wait for the cycle to end, and it's going to turn off. Great. Drones are still attacking this, which is fantastic. Once they attack it, once it's done, activate target painter. So the drones are immediately going to start attacking this one. So it's very, very quick. and it is pretty AFK. If you have a look at my ult, it's not getting any damage at all. It's going over 1,000 meters a second, 1,100 meters a second. It's cap stable with the afterburner on. Drones aren't getting any damage, so it's just sitting there quite nicely. So I can basically AFK that one, and I just need to focus on my main and focus on what targets my main is attacking. So now I'll put the auto painter on the next target and activate my drones on the next target as well. And I just find that this is just the it's a very easy setup, and it's obviously twice as quick doing a sight as if you were doing it with just one character. So you get basically twice the amount of money per tick as you normally would. Oh, slipped up a bit there. Let's get some of these smaller guys down. So yeah, as you can see, they're now attacking my main, and they're not really doing any damage. Some of them are hitting, some of them are completely missing. So it's a lot less stressful than carrier ratting. Carrier ratting, you have to watch your fighters like a hawk. You really do, because the rats do like going after your fighters quite a lot. And I always tend to lose one or two of them. And it's not a very nice experience when you lose $4 million fighter to rats every sight that you do. It can get quite discouraging. But doing sights with drones, heavy drones like this, as long as you make sure the rats target you first before you activate your drones, then the rats tend to leave your drones alone. So it's a lot more hassle-free doing this. And again, because of the target painter, you could have as many ults as you want helping you out. I've done it with my main character and two ults, and that's worked out fine. It's just that as soon as you land, there's just a lot you need to do before you can actually sit down and relax, and that's to basically get every one of your ults moving, orbiting at 30k, and assigning your drones to assist your main character. But once that's all set up, it's pretty AFK, which is fantastic. But I just find, I mean, it's just nice and relaxing if you just use two ults, or two characters, I should say. It's just, just very relaxing, and the money does start coming in. You do quite a few of these sites pretty quickly. So that's the thing. The only trouble is if you don't maintain an active target, the alt drones do tend to come back to you and orbit you. They don't stay on field, so if you leave them idle for any period of time, it just takes them a bit longer to reactivate or re-engage the target that you select. So it's always best to keep them on an active target, just to speed up the whole process. So there's a little bit of management that you need to do, a little bit of timings that you need to get right, i.e. activate the target painter once the target's getting attacked, deactivate the target painter so it cycles down and ready for the next target that you paint for the drones. But anyway, so what I'll do is I will finish the site, and I will go and actually do one more, so at least we get a tick in. And I'll come back to you. So sit back and enjoy.
another day.
Okay, and there we have it, folks. So we did three sites. So I'll just turn the afterburners off and return the drones to the drone bay. And yeah, we'll see what we got for the ticks. So let's have a look. Oop, wrong one. Journal is what we want. Okay. That's pretty good. So for the first tick that we got, which was I guess only a partial sight, we got 12.7 million. So that's per character. So let's just calculate that. 12.7 plus 16.9 for the second tick, and for a third tick we got 13.7. so in total that's 43.3 million for those three ticks that we did, times two, that's 86.6 million which is pretty good going considering. I mean, this is semi-AFK, it's very relaxing. Yeah, as you saw, I didn't get into trouble at all with any of the rats. The shields on both characters were just, you know, performing phenomenally. Yeah, none of them got, even halfway through the shields. They were basically doing no damage or hardly any damage at all on either of the characters that I'm flying. So yeah, V&I's are great ships. They're very, very tanky ships compared to the rats. And yeah, it's an easy way to make money. As I said, if you've got two of them or two characters or three characters that can fly them, it's great to put them in a fleet and have two of your alts assigning the drones to your main, and your main obviously needs to have a target painter, and then you're set to go. Very AFK to do it. And as you saw as well, even though we did three sites, so far we've got that much money, which is fantastic. But, don't know if you saw, but in the first site, I actually got a true Sansha drop. And that gives you, it basically drops faction gear. So what I've got is I've got a Sansha microwave large crystal to use for laser weapons. And I've got here a heatsink as well, a true Sansha heatsink, which is fantastic. And I don't know if anyone's selling these at the moment or not. Oh yeah, they are. Okay, so we're looking at around 90 to 100 million for this true Sansha heatsink. So that's a fantastic drop. That's really, really good. The only downside is we didn't get any escalations, which is a pity. Because I do actually have a ship that I have flown through a 10 out of 10, and it was really, really easy to do. I'll show that when we dock up. But yeah, so this is great. So yeah, heavy drones, or tech 2 drones, or faction drones is what you need to do this. V&I's with the fit that I've shown you as well, very, very tanky and easy to do these sites. And I don't know if you saw, but what I did for the last two sites as well is I just bookmarked them. So what I'll do later on is I'll come back with a salvager and just salvage all these wrecks. So what we'll do is we'll dock up and I will show you the ship that I normally do escalations in. It's a very, 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 very tanky ship, and if you probably guessed, it's a Tangu. So I'll quickly warp back and show you that ship. Back to the Forza. Oh, and they're actually flying in formation for once. Pretty good. Ooh, bit of lag there. Alright, let's dock up. I'll dock up my other character as well. Alright, go back to the first one. Alright, so here is my Tangu that I do escalations in. It is a very, very, very tanky ship. Brilliant Tangu. As you can see, actually that's probably not a good way to show you. If I show you in the ship tree, yeah, as you can see, Tangu, the majority of the subsystems are level 4. The only subsystem is the strategic cruiser, which is level 3 at the moment. But yeah, so level 4 for the majority of all the subsystems. And if I show you the fit, okay, what we have is for the high slots. Oh, actually, what I've got is I've got this in the this is my travel fit. So let's change it out because we don't want that, do we? We want the actual proper fit. Take that out. Okay, fine, we'll just put that in the fleet hanger. And these are rage, so we'll put a rage in there. We'll take these out as well. And we will add, if there's enough space, we'll add our. There is already something in that location. Yes, I know there is. Right, there we go, that's better. Right. So this is the fit. Sorry about that. So what we've got up here is we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So we've got 6 heavy assault missile launcher Tech 2s with the Rage heavy assault missiles, which do 249 HP EM damage per missile. For the mid slots, we have our Type B 10NM afterburner. That lets a Tangu go, as it says there, around 644 meters a second. So it just gets it moving, so it doesn't take as much damage. We have our A-type medium shield booster that gives us 463 HP bonus every 3 seconds. We have our X-type EM ward field, which again resists up to 64% of EM damage, which is fantastic. We have our X-type shield boost amplifier and our X-type EM ward field as well, same as that. So 2 of these EM ward field faction modules. And then last mid slot, we've got our missile guidance computer Tech 2 with a missile range script in there. And for the low slots, as you can see, we've got 4 Kadari Navy ballistic control systems. For the mid slots, we've just got our EM screen reinforcer Tech 2 and 2 medium capacitor control circuit Tech 2s as well. So this is it. It's pretty pricey. I think it was about 1.2, 1.3 billion-isk for this. But it definitely makes easier work of DED sites, 10 out of 10s. You can do them in about 30 to 40 minutes, very comfortably. Hardly have to use your shield booster active module, which is, you know, there's a couple occasions where you just want to just get your shields repaired pretty quickly, so you just turn that on for a couple of cycles and that's it. Every now and then it's not that difficult. It's really, really easy to manage. It's not cap stable, but you know, if you have to run this all the time, you're in big trouble anyway. So that's the only reason why your cap would go down, is if you had to use this all the time. And as I said, if you're using that all the time, then you're doing something majorly wrong, because you don't need to. So if you manage it properly, you don't get into tight situations, and you use your cap booster sparingly, you're not going to run out of cap. And as I said, it makes quick work of DED 10 out of 10 sites. You can do them in about, you know, 30 to 40 minutes. So it's very comfortably. It is a bit of a blingy ship, but again, I like doing sights comfortably. I don't have to have to worry about what I'm doing too much. I just get too stressed out over it. So if you can, you can, you know, just pay a bit more to get the better modules, to get the faction modules, and it just makes life easier when you run sites, combat sites, and DED sites. But that's a ship. I will show you that in a future video. Once I get some more DED site escalations, I'll definitely be video recording them for you, and running my Tango, and showing you what I do. But as you saw, we actually got the last little bit of the tick coming in, which was another 8 million. So yeah, it's pretty good. So that's a, you know, just running those three sites. Didn't take us long at all. I'm not sure how long this video is. Let's have a look. Hold on, let's just bring up. Yeah, so this video is just running just about an hour and 20 minutes or so. So yeah, those three sites probably took us 40 minutes. Yeah, I guess just under 20 minutes per site. So yeah, it's not a bad payday. I mean, it's quite comfortably quite comfortable to do those sites. They do go down quick if you've got two VNIs. And yeah, so that's it. So that's all I have for you today. Until the next video, fly safe, and I'll catch you next time. Bye for now.